Love all.
One
off. Nice push there. Less rotation on it as the ball carries off. Again, short pips for Sean Chouinard, which means more flat hitting and not quite as much spin as one might expect.
Left. One off.
After all, the more common rubber would be inverted rubber, where the pips are inverted, turned inwards, so it's smooth and spinny where the ball is contacted.
Left two.
But able to generate some spin just the same. Might not be as much, but it's still enough to earn the point. Sean Chouinard converting both of her serves. It'll help off the top of the net for Zhang Jian.
Two.
Pendulum serve deep to the backhand. From time to time, she'll do that against the pen holder. You can hear the difference in sound, too. A little bit more like cork. That light racket with less rubber on it. Now, rackets get weighed. People often weighing them to make sure they glue just right. Don't want to do too many layers, nor too few, to make sure they have the right spring effect.
3-2.
But a lot of the weight on a racket is the rubber. The rubber is the heavier part, so Sean Chouinard's racket is going to be one of, if not the lightest, in this entire competition.
3-0.
Zhang Jian ties it up here, first towel break. Again, for those of you newer to the sport, towel breaks allowed every 6 points. Now that pen hold grip, much the way you would hold a pen, I'm actually holding one right now. You can see Sean Chouinard. She's able to cover the middle, the difference between a forehand and a backhand. As she rips this
forehand,
is that you don't actually have to put your racket in a place where you can't contact the ball. For Zhang Jian, it's not the same. If she's caught in the middle, it'll hit the edge of the racket. Tough to rally with Sean Chouinard when she steps around for the forehand. 2-point lead here for the German veteran, racket high for the traditional pen hold backhand. Zhang Jian playing that wisely. Sean Chouinard found herself just a step behind the table and tried to move back in. Looked to step around, but Zhang Jian in perfect position, then goes deep to the backhand corner, says good luck stepping around this. 1 point between them now. Oh man, footwork. Tested here as Zhang Jian goes down the line. Another look at that high toss serve. It's got to be about 3 times the height of Sean Chouinard.
Yeah. 5-6.
Got a handful of high tossers here. Yuan Jianan, Sean Chouinard, Hugo Calderano, the three that stand out for me. And every time Sean Chouinard pulls out a lead, Zhang Jian brings it right back, ropes her in. Jing Junhong in the corner for Zhang Jian. Jing Junhong there also played, I think came to world number 3 playing for China before she came to Singapore. Heavy spin on the move, Zhang Jian keeping herself protected with that top spin. Top spin is crucial. If you're getting into table tennis, a lot of people ask, when should I get a professional racket? Now, I'm not one to tell people to go and spend a lot of money, but the truth is, as soon as possible, get one as soon as possible.
8-6.
And the reason is, if you start playing with a racket that's not professional, you develop a lot of bad habits that are tough to unlearn. You want to get your kid into the sport? Your kid, you want to get into the sport? Get good grades, tell your parents why you deserve a professional racket.
Nine, six.
or save up allowance, or turn your room into a music lab. No, here we go. 3 points in front. Tung Jian with a massive turnaround here. Serious momentum swing for Singapore right now. And steady and secure. Sean Xiaonao's greatest weapons have not been able to come out in some time. 4 game points now for Tung Jian. Oh my goodness, the cracking forehand. Is it a let serve? Some people ask, are you saying let or net? And the answer is let. If you ask why, because a let basically means pause, redo. No point awarded. And a let doesn't have to involve a net. A let could happen if a ball came flying in from another court, if players started playing before a ball kid had cleared the area. There's a long list of reasons, but right now, Sean Xiaonao is looking for a long list of answers. Tied up at 1 point apiece. Not easy to do. Tung Jian survives a big one and nearly a second. Heavy spin, side chop lock there, side underspin. Remember, flatter shots from Sean Xiaonao, the short pips. She'll spin if she has to, but she'll try not to. You can see that fast, aggressive shot. Security for Tung Jian. If she can keep it low and deep on the table, it's going to force Sean Xiaonao to spin the ball a little bit more, which buys Tung Jian time to counterattack. Tamara Boros, as her opponent, has won 6 of the last 8 points. Tung Jian still in control and in the lead by 1. What a move here. Tung Jian looked like she might have been going the wrong way, but still managed to make a winner out of that ball. Take a look here, starts to turn, played to the middle, perfect cover, testing Sean Xiaonao, the hamstrings attached. Up and to the right, planning for the future.
Two, five. Three.
2-point game here. This is a 10-year anniversary of when Tung Jian came to Singapore and has been representing the Singaporean flag quite proudly for some time now. Oh, the angle here. Sean Xiaonao not taking any risk in terms of stepping around to the forehand, taking all the risk with going deep to that corner. She keeps it subtle, little bit of the edge of the table. That's why she raises her hand. Why do players apologize for nets and edges? Well, it wasn't part of the plan, and it gave them a lucky advantage.
5-0.
Interesting. Normally, you would see one there as well. Singapore, Jiao. Several languages here in Singapore, including Mandarin and English. Actually heard Tamil was one of the official languages here from Tamil Nadu, southern state in India, where Satyan Ñanashekaran, my brother from another mother, slash same mother, my biological brother comes from. 1-point game here. Sean Xiaonao looking to pull ahead where she can, or at least level the playing field. clever. Sean Shawna held back instead of going for the big attack to keep the ball placed to the backhand and change the rhythm. This one right there. Instead of cross court, she says, I'm playing for positioning, and forces her opponent to backpedal a bit into that corner. And you can see how the ball barely bounces at all off that hard Chinese forehand rubber for Zheng Jian. It is so difficult to keep the weight on the balls of your feet in this rally. Somehow Zheng Jian manages to do it. But Sean Shawna with the streak now is back in front.
6-7.
Moments ago was down. And Sean Shawna has already outscored her high score of game number one at 6.
8-6.
Interesting. Chole. Tomaboros possibly, but Sean Shawna finding ways to get her forehand into play where she wants it. She's not having to step around as much. She's trusting her backhand, and that's paying off well. It's keeping her in position.
8-7.
Zheng Jian with a change up down the line. A little bit slower and spinny in the position. Just enough to keep Sean Shawna guessing. Sean Shawna keeping the hand cool, keeping it dry, just to keep the ball dry. That's the responsibility of the server.
No.
Meaning,
7-9.
If there's a wet ball and you miss, because let's say you were on the receive and the ball was wet, you could replay it. If you're the server and you miss your third ball or the serve because the ball's wet, no chance for a replay. You show the umpire your racket, doesn't matter. That was your responsibility. Footwork tested, and the work pays off. Zheng Jian moves back into the table to take it early and make sure she can find the angle. That was cool. A little bit of reflection there. Zheng Jian moving forward with every stroke. Weight on the balls of the feet. Sean Shawna's parents, both players.
10-8.
And she's got two game points here, making the family proud if she can get one more before Zheng Jian crosses that, well, reaches deuce anyway. Again, setting up the positioning well, these subtle differences in the serve and receive game, and the decision to play the backhand. Two game points for Sean Shawna. Zheng Jian takes her chances on the step around, and it pays off. One game point saved. Singapore fans like it. With two Singaporeans eliminated in the round of 64 in the Infinity Arena, Singapore would love to see Zheng Jian move on through. 10-9. Sean Shawna to the open forehand side of the table silences the crowd. Starting off game number three tied up, Sean Shawna with some momentum. But Zheng Jian in the touch game shuts down the attack, a nice push. Best option, whenever possible, taking the ball early, generally speaking. And in the pushing game, it gives you that many more options and gives your opponent less time to respond. Ayah, high toss. This is why she looks up to test the light, just to make sure she's not tossing the ball directly into the light. You'll notice Sean Shawna a lot of the time is deeper from the table. I think this toss was just a little close to the table. The head back could have been more of an ayah than looking up at the lights.
Yo.
2-1.
In case you're curious about aya, meaning sort of like oops or oof in Spanish. I guess every language has its sort of could be oh no. Two serving one, Singapore's Zheng Jian.
Wow, free.
Quality spin here. I like the crowd. The crowd knows their table tennis. They didn't shout and cheer in that moment because they felt that it was a little bit of a lucky escape. They encouraged Zheng Jian, but they didn't celebrate Sean Xiaona's, say, non-conversion there.
2-3.
Remember, head-to-head, according to the tail of the table, this is their first ever meeting. Amazing control on that high toss. You might be wondering, why would a player toss the ball that high? Wouldn't it make it tougher? Ah, the footwork. Net ball comes up a little bit high. Now, this is an example where the player who received the net acknowledges the fortune because it gave her such a free ball on an otherwise low shot, still plays it right near the line. It's what it takes at this level to get a point sometimes. So the high toss, why do it? Well, the ball comes into the racket with more speed, which means you can generate more spin and more speed, but it takes more work to control not only the toss, but the contact.
4-3.
On top of the bounce and in control, Sean Xiaona not allowing much chance here in the rally. On the rise, if you can, just like the push, get it early. And Sean Xiaona comfortable with the topspin, the quality of that ball coming in. This is exactly what Sean Xiaona wants. This is her style. Good spin deep to the backhand. Zheng Jian creating a new vibe here right out of the timeout. Showing a bit of mojo back in the hand. The hand that she keeps cool for full control.
Six, five.
Testing the short forehand side too. You could say half long. But for a player who's got the grip, Sean Xiaona does. There are two things. If you can surprisingly play the ball there, it's going to be incredibly effective.
5-7.
I say surprisingly because the penhold grip favors the forehand and it also favors over the table play. The penhold grip, the reason for that is you have more wrist flexibility. It's a shorter handle on a penhold racket. The handle on a shake hands racket gets in the way for some of these wristy shots inside the table. Sean Xiaona works hard for this one.
6-7.
Zheng Jian was refusing to back up. And I think that's going to be crucial for her to stay in the points. This is the thing, both players don't want to be behind the table. Sean Xiaona, you could argue even more so, just because she only has one side of the racket to use and she's 41.
7-all.
The closer to the table you can stand, the better it'll be. That's how little rotation there is on the toss. Incredible shot there. The camera work, really. 7 points apiece. And a good response this time around from Sean Xiaona. But table tennis at this level is rarely about one shot. It's about combinations. It's about recovery. Sean Xiaona makes the big opening shot, but Zheng Jian knows what to do, baits her into the short forehand side. And deep to the backhand as well.
Nine.
A pinning shot. Zheng Jian says, okay, this is right. This is what you need to do. Remember, Singapore will be thrilled to have one of their hometown heroes, Singaporean, move on to the round of 32. It's such a big marquee event.
7-9.
Sean Xiaona's got her
Eight,
where she wants
nine.
Her and keeps her there with persistent, pounding shots from the forehand. The placement as well, deep to the backhand, then wide to the forehand. A few parallels there before she creates the opening, and then it's the early timing to put it away. And now game, nope. Game on, as the floor would have you know here.
Let 8-9.
Game tighter, you could say. 1 point between them now. Still Zheng Jian with the lead. And now it is game point. Two times over, the smiles start to come out. Guarded optimism from Jing Junhong. Very low to the net, these shots in this rally. At the third towel break, serves, should there be a second one, will be with the player who has game points and the home court advantage. Again, barely any bounce on that forehand. It's all spin and tackiness on the top sheet. Sean Xiaonan saves one. That is the Chinese rubber. There's a lot to talk about there. Why, how it's used, and why players who were born and raised in Europe, you don't see using that equipment very much. It takes different technique to carry that heavy rubber and to generate the racket speed needed. Oh, the edge of the table, down the line. She takes her face. So Zheng Jian to start it off, game number four with a 2-1 lead over Sean Xiaona.
A
little bit off the top of the net there. Sean Xiaona offers her apologies. Ooh. Welcome to Singapore. Little gift from Zheng Jian. The angle on this one as the parallel comes in. The thing is, Sean Xiaona has to step around to play it. Turns the corner. It's not a lot of space, but Zheng Jian manages to find it. Sean Xiaona giving herself a little slap on the wrist as if to say, you know better. Easier said than done, but this is the adjustment that she made after game number one. Game number one, Sean Xiaona was not able to get the forehand in because she took it from the backhand corner quite a lot and was punished to the open forehand side.
Let to all. Two, three.
Come on, Nana, says Tamara Borosh. Sometimes it's not tactics. Sometimes it's just a reminder that you've got somebody else there cheering you on. Heavy spin deep to the backhand side. Zheng Jian taking advantage of her style of play here. Remember, two clashing styles, not just because one player, Sean Xiaona, is a pen holder, because she's using the traditional style. Penhold used to only use one side of the racket. And as Sweden started to dominate China, China said, we've got to do something about this, and created, timeout now for Sean Xiaona. The step around pays off. Able to make it count on this one. It's a fine balance, stepping around. It's a question of when. Shot selection, timing is everything. The timing on this, there's not much for Sean Xiaona to complain about. That ball goes to infinity and beyond off the edge of the racket. Short side of the table, less time to react, and the fist clinched in dizzied. An angle on this one, like we haven't seen before from Sean Xiaona. Now remember, with the short pips, she can't generate quite as much spin, so Sean Xiaona rarely tries for heavy side spin shots, like we saw from Ma Long earlier tonight. Now my German isn't super, but that shot sure was, according to Tamara Boros and pretty much anyone watching. Sean Shana making it very difficult here in game four for Zheng Jian. And again, the timing, the quick follow-up, decision-making. This is one of the key things, one of the most important things at this level. Players have all the strokes. Sean Shana making the quick decision has won 6 of the last 8 points. From behind the table, Zheng Jian managing to keep the quality on and keep it baseline. Smart play, Sean Shaona hits the middle and then gets Zheng Jian to lean. And by doing that, Zheng Jian, take a look. So it was that lean to the middle. Again, middle relative to the player, not the table. Hits it right at Zheng Jian's elbow, so she has to lean off balance. And then there's a sense of panic, a natural responsibility to cover the wide forehand. Spin as well, and Sean Shaona with 5 game points to send this one to the decider. Now on paper, this is the match that seemed most likely to go the distance today. It's looking close. Not yet. Zheng Jian down the line takes her chances. Knows it's a possibility. We'll be ready to fight in game 5, but that's not where we are right now. Zheng Jian saves 2. Remember, both players have called their timeouts already. 10-5 is a pretty massive lead. Yet in the last 3 points, Zheng Jian has been flawless. She's been cool. She's been focused. Which doesn't imply that it's not the same on the other side, but in an adversarial sport, both players can be playing incredibly well, but the better one tends to win the point. Ten serving 8, 2 game points here for Sean Shaona. And there it is. We are going to the D, to the side, to the der. Germany's Sean Shaona starting off the decider.
One.
The rocket out of the forehand, the hammering pen hold power as Sean Shaona takes her chances to cover the middle here. Steps around but keeps the weight forward on the balls of the feet, leaning into the table.
One hole.
I talked about how light the racket is of Sean Shaona, but as we saw that close up of the rubber on her forehand, the short pips. Not as much of the racket head is actually covered by the pips. There's a significant portion there where the finger fits. And that adds to the lightness. Or you could say subtracts from the weight. But here's a traditional racket. Zheng Jian's got rubber all the way to the baseline there, right to the edge of the handle.
Too old.
This is a bit of an escape here. Sean Shaona roaring because she did have to run, wasn't in the best position, but still managed to find the answer and win the point.
Let. Too old. Two, 3.
But in the push game, deep to the backhand will be effective if Sean Shaona is not in a perfect position to step around. Interesting, that 4-leaf clover there next to Sean Shaona's name. Curious to know more about that.
Sorry.
A little bit off the edge here. 4-leaf clover typically means good luck. If you find one. Leaves of 3, let them be. Don't eat them, nor touch them. Don't put them on the back of your shirts either. Only the ones with four leaves. They'll get you the edges. 3 points apiece out of the first towel break. Whoever wins this game collects a lot more prize money and points. Sung Jian, how did you pull this off? Leaping forward. It was self-defense. It's a fine balance of self-defense to quickly turning it to the attack. Take a look one more time.
Play, please.
Pounded down, and as soon as it's a little slower, leaps and takes it forward. Really moving forward. Dead even for the last 32 points. That's pretty crazy when you think about how many points have been played in a game. In a close game, you're talking about 20 points, right? 11-9, it's 20 points. There's 16-16 before this last one for the last 32. 2-2, 4-4, dead even. After this point, they'll switch sides of the table as it is the decider to keep things fair and square. Chop block carries long, and it is Sung Jian who gets that advantage here as they switch sides. Light underspin. Chop block-esque. Little bit of side spin with the potentially top spin. So maybe not quite a chop block, but still a bit of side spin on it. Four serving five here for Nana. Takes two in this one. Sung Jian withstands the first. Right at the baseline. But still, Sean Xiaona doesn't back off the table. Sung Jian did nearly everything right.
Six, five.
A fine balance of options here. In general, the theory is whoever attacks first has the advantage, but it depends on the quality of that attack and it depends on positioning and what you're leaving open. No, she didn't. No, Nana was on one leg in this point. Footwork, she's not the favorite here. The chase, the punch hopped up, and the short stroke to the open side of the table. Oh, dismissive, the coverage. Cho indeed. Full flex mode here from Tamara Borosz. Reminder that she's keeping in good shape, even though not playing professionally anymore. Gotta be to be the coach at the top level.
Go! 7-6.
I take that back. It helps to be. I was thinking of other coaches here. There are some that are just books, wealths of knowledge. 1 point in front, Sean Xiaona.
Six, eight.
The Chole from Tamara Borosz up on her feet as Sean Xiaona finds a way to get Sung Jian off balance. One thing I will say about the traditional penhold style, you just don't see it as much anymore, so it's tough to predict. That's part of the reason Sean Xiaona is able to get these backhand blocks and punches where Sung Jian is starting to move the other way. Six of the last 8 points to Sean Xiaona. And now it is four game and match points to Germany's Sean Xiaona. Make them say, oh, na-na-na-na, Sean Xiaona, 3-2.